Hey, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Q. You know who you are. Back, baby, with another video. Thank y'all for coming kicking it with me today, man. So today I want to talk about offset. What is offset? Because I get a lot of questions via Instagram or in the comments. What's my offset? What's my setup on my truck? So in this video, I'm gonna do my best to explain what offset is. Ideally, you would like to have a wheel here that you can see, because you're just gonna have to basically follow me visually as I talk about what's going on here. It's kind of hard to explain, but you gotta really see it. So I'm gonna do my best to explain this with the setup that I have here. So my setup on my truck, I have a 6-inch Rough Country lift kit. My tires are 35 by 12.5 by 20 Nitto Ridge grapplers. My wheel, when I say wheel, my actual rim is going to be 20 by 10. So what I mean by 35. So 35, that basically means the tire is 35 inches tall. So from here to here is 35 inches. When I say 12.5, that means it's gonna be 12.5 wide. So here to here, I say by 20, that's going to be the diameter of my wheel. So this here from here to here is going to be 20 inches. That's your diameter. When you talk about offset, I guess you can say there's three measurements for offsets. You're gonna have zero, which is basically gonna be our neutral, and then you're gonna have positive, and you're gonna have negative. I first started researching, probably a lot of you, I thought positive offset gave you that stance, right? When I say stance, that means how much the wheel stick out from the body of the truck. That's actually incorrect. When your wheels stick out like that, that is negative offset. Zero is neutral, positive means more in, negative means more out, more poke, more stance, right? Let's go ahead and start here. So basically what determines offset is where the wheel, basically your mounting point, where this mounts to the actual vehicle, right? That determines your offset. When I say this, you gotta think about the backside, the actual mounting point on the backside there. That's gonna determine your offset. So let's say we draw a line right down the middle of the thing. That's gonna be zero. That's gonna be neutral. So let's say where this mounts up here is right in the middle of the wheel. That's gonna give you your zero neutral offset, right? So if we're gonna go like a positive offset, let's say here's right down the middle of the wheel. If we're mounting more here, that's gonna create a positive offset because the mounting point of the wheel is closer into the vehicle. So you're gonna get a positive offset. So if the mounting point is here, that's gonna create more of a negative offset, because as soon as you mount the tire to the frame of the truck here, all the wheel is gonna be sticking out, right? So you see what I'm saying? So you mount it back here, you have all the rest of this wheel sticking out, giving you more stance. If you mount it here, this wheel has to push further into the truck, so it's gonna sit more flush. You won't see as much poke. So that's how you get your offset. It's basically gonna be determined where your mounting point, where this wheel mounts up to the truck, right? That's basically what it's gonna determine. I have a negative 24 offset on my truck. So as you can see, it's negative. Why? Because negative means the wheels sit outside the fender here of the truck. So I have more stance, more of the wheels outside the inside. I have a negative offset. This is a 20 by 10 wheel. Typically with a 20 by 10 wheel, you're probably gonna be around negative 24 offset. So let's talk about how do you get a positive offset. So if you're running a 18 by 9, 20 by 9, 22 by 9, anything like that, you're gonna probably have a positive offset. Let's say if you want a negative offset, you're probably gonna be running 20 by 10, 20 by 12, 20 by 14. What ultimately determines the offset, and this is not a rule of thumb, it's the width. So how wide the wheel is gonna determine your offset. A lot of people say, I'm gonna get some 20, they're on 20 by 9s, right? They have a positive offset. They say, I'm gonna get 22 by 9s. You just changed the diameter from here to here. You didn't change the width of your wheel. So the wheel is still gonna mount the same point. You're just gonna be taller, right? You're just gonna have more rim. So that's like, oh, I'm gonna do 22 by 9s or 24 by 9s. You're still not changing your offset. What changed your offset? If like right now I'm running the 20 by 10. If I went 20 by 12, that's gonna push me out to like a negative 44 offset. Why? Because my width of my wheel now is wider. So from here to here has gotten wider, which means more of the wheel is gonna push out away from the truck. Let's say I went 14 wide, now my wheel got 4 inches wider this way, which means it's gonna stick out further from the truck. And that's why you see those old people with those 14 wides, you have that really, really aggressive stand where the wheel sits like way out here. Another thing that goes is backspacing. Backspacing and offset are not the same thing, they're actually two separate things. So what backspacing is basically the space on the back of the wheel from the hub mounting point. So when I say wheel, I mean the rim. It's the back, y'all ain't better see me, so just picture this. It's the back of the actual rim and the space between that, the wheel and the mounting point, that your hub, how much space, that's going to be your backspace. I hope I did an okay job explaining this. It's very hard to explain with it being on the truck. You just sum this whole thing up. Positive offset basically means the tire wheel, you're going to have more of a flush look. You will not see any tire sticking out. All your wheel and tire is going to be inside the fender. Negative offset is what I have. You see my tire sticks out from the body of the truck. Hopefully they helped y'all out. Catch y'all next piece.